We are discussing unit 1, interference, diffraction and polarization. In our previous video, we have seen interference due to uniform thickness thin film. In this video, we will discuss interference due to wave-shaped thin film. So, objectives of this particular lesson are to discuss the phenomenon of light like interference, diffraction and polarization and their applications. To derive equations for bright and dark fringes due to interference of light through thin films, to discuss the diffraction grating theory and its applications, to explain concept of double refraction, optical activity and their engineering applications. And in this particular video, we will derive the equations for bright and dark for interference due to wave-shaped thin film. So, wave-shaped thin film, we all know it has thickness at one end 0 and on the other end the thickness goes on increasing. So, here you can see at this particular end, one end the thickness is 0 and that makes an angle alpha. So, here the wave angle is given by alpha. Let's consider a ray AB is incident on this particular wave-shaped thin film. I will give a notation later. So, this is incident ray AB. As we know, the ray undergoes partial reflection and refraction like this. The reflected ray is ray BE and refracted ray is ray BC. Again, at point C, that is at the bottom surface, the ray that means here the ray undergo again partial reflection and refraction, but refracted ray is not shown. We will show only reflected ray like this. Again at this point, the ray undergoes partial reflection and refraction, but herein we will show only refracted ray. Okay, so at point D the ray gets refracted into air again, that is ray DI. Now, as you can see here, this AB, BC, CD and DI, these notations we have purposefully chosen same as that of our previous point. Now, let's draw normal to the upper surface and lower surface of the thin film. The normal get intersect at with each other at a point, say point P. If the surfaces, that is top surface and bottom surface, they have this particular angle alpha in between them, then the normal, they must have the same angle between each other. So, this angle must be angle alpha. Now, let's draw normal to the reflected and refracted ray from this point D. So, this reflected ray, on reflected ray BE, the normal is a normal DG. On refracted ray, the normal is a normal DF. Now, let's draw some more construction in the diagram. Let's draw normal to the, before that we will see the angles. The angle of incidence we consider as angle I. Then angle of refraction, of course, we consider as angle R. So, this is angle I, this is angle R. Angle of reflection is same as that of I. So, this is also I. As it is outer angle to this particular angle, this angle is also angle R. Again, the angle of refraction R is outer angle to this particular angle. So, this angle is also angle R. Now, this angle is alpha, so this angle is also alpha. So, in this triangle, triangle BCP, one angle is angle R, second angle is angle alpha. So, the remaining angle, it must be 180 minus R plus alpha. And this is straight line. CP is a straight line. So, this angle, it must be R plus alpha. Okay, so one angle is 180 minus R plus alpha, so second angle must be R plus alpha. Now, this angle is angle of incidence for this particular ray BC. So, the reflected ray, it will make the same angle with the normal. So, this angle is also angle R plus alpha. Now let's draw a normal from point D to the bottom surface of that thin film. So here we have also extended this ray BC along the same direction. So the normal from that point D and this BC extended ray, they meet at each other at point, say point Q. Now here this angle and angle CDQ, they are alternate angles, and therefore this angle D is also R plus alpha. Now this is straight line BCQ, it is straight line, and here you can see this angle on one side of this ray CD, the angle is R plus alpha plus R plus alpha, that means it is 2R plus alpha. So the remaining angle, it must be 180 minus 2 into R plus alpha. Now consider this triangle DCQ. In this triangle, one angle is this 180 minus 2 into R plus alpha. Second angle is R plus alpha. So the third angle, it must be R plus alpha. Now the base angles of this particular triangle, they are same, and therefore this particular triangle is isosceles triangle. So in this isosceles triangle, this side CD, it must be equal to CQ. So CD and CQ, they must be equal. Now let's find out path difference between this ray BE and DI. We have drawn normal to find out path difference only. So path difference between this ray BE and DI, it seems to be BG. But when this ray BE, it covers this distance BG in air, simultaneously or meanwhile, this ray DI, it covers the distance of BC plus CD, and that is within the thin film of refractive index mu. So path difference between this ray BE and DI, it must be this mu into BC plus CD minus BG. But again, what happened at this point B? Here it is reflected ray from denser medium, and when light ray gets reflected from denser medium, a small path difference of lambda by 2 gets added. So it gets added to this path difference of BG. So the final path difference equation that we get is between the BE and DI, it is mu into BC plus CD minus BG plus lambda by 2. Now we have to find out what are the expressions for BC, CD and BG in measurable quantities, because these distances, they are very small, so we cannot measure in reality. So we have to find out expressions for them. So first of all, we'll find out expression for BG. Now to find out expression for BG, we have to consider this particular triangle, triangle BGD. In this triangle, this angle is I, BG is opposite to this, so we have to consider sine I. So sin I is equal to BG upon BD. Then BG is equal to BD into sin I. Again, we have to find out this expression for BD. Now to find out expression for BD, let's consider triangle BDF. In this triangle, this is angle R. So if we take this sin R, then it is BF opposite side. BF upon hypotenuse is BD. So sin R is equal to BF upon BD. From this expression, BD is equal to BF upon sin R. So let's put it here. BG is equal to BD sin I, and hence BG is equal to BF upon sin R into sin I. So sin I by sin R, it becomes mu, and hence this expression for BG becomes mu into BF. So let's put this expression for BG as mu into BF. Here I have also made written BC is equal to BF plus FC, because this is straight line, so for BC we can write BF plus FC, right? So our path difference equation now is mu into BF plus FC plus CD, I have kept as it is, minus mu BF expression for BG plus lambda by 2, and that is equal to this mu BF case gets cancelled out, and it is equal to mu into FC plus CD, that is the remaining quantity, minus lambda by 2. Now FC plus CD, here CD can be written as CQ. CD can be equal to CQ since it is isosceles triangle. So FC plus CD, instead of CD we can write CQ, and this becomes FC plus CQ. So FC plus CQ we can write as FQ, and hence the path difference equation becomes equal to mu into FQ minus lambda by 2. Now we have to find out expression for FQ. Now if you see this particular triangle, triangle DFQ, in this triangle we don't know this angle, we don't know this angle, but we know this particular angle Q, that is R plus alpha, and FQ is adjacent side to this R plus alpha. So in this triangle, if we take cos R plus alpha, then it is equal to FQ upon hypotenuse DQ. Now this DQ is equal to T plus T. We consider thickness at point D, thickness of the thin film at point T as at point D is T. Okay, and it is isosceles triangle. So this half and this half, they must be same. And therefore DQ is equal to 2T. So FQ is equal to 2T cos R plus alpha. Right? So now we have got this expression for FQ. We can put here in above equation, and our equation for path difference becomes 2T into mu, that is 2 mu T cos R plus alpha minus lambda by 2. So this is the final path difference equation, because we can measure mu, we can measure thickness, we can measure angle of refraction and wedge angle, and hence we get this expression in measurable quantities. Now we know the conditions for bright and dark. When this path difference is equal to n plus minus 1 half into lambda, we get condition for bright. So when we put this is equal to n lambda for bright fringe, we know that when this path difference is equal to n lambda, we get condition for bright, and when this path difference is equal to n lambda, the final expression for constructive interference is, by taking this lambda by 2 on the other side, we get n plus 1 half into lambda. So this gives us one side bright fringes. If we add minus, then we get the bright fringes on both sides of the central fringe. So 2 mu t cos R plus alpha is equal to n plus minus 1 half into lambda. This is for constructive interference. Then for destructive interference or dark fringe, we know the condition and that is path difference is equal to n plus minus 1 half into lambda. So we can choose minus 1 half into lambda. When we choose minus 1 half into lambda, lambda by 2 on both sides gets cancelled out, and the final expression for destructive interference we get as 2 mu t cos R plus alpha equal to n lambda. So here we have seen interference due to wedge shaped thin film. We can use this particular equation to find out refractive index of the thin film, to find out thickness of the thin film, to find out wavelength of the incident light. We can also find out the wedge angle or angle of refraction from this particular study or from this particular equation. We can also use this interference due to wedge shaped thin film to study the flatness of the lenses. So we can also find out fringe width for this interference fringes, and the final expression for that fringe width is given by beta equal to lambda upon 2 mu alpha. So here is the reflection spot for you. Which type of fringes do we get in interference pattern obtained due to wedge shaped thin film? So it is wedge shaped thin film. So what do you think, whether we get straight, parallel or equidistant fringes as given in option 1, or we get curved with variable widths fringes as given in option B? So you can think over it. It is wedge shaped thin film. You can pause the video and you can find the answer. So I hope you have got your answer now. So here The type of fringes that we get in the wedge-shaped thin film interference, they are straight fringes and not curved fringes or variable thickness fringes. But we get straight, parallel and equidistant fringes. So, why? Because fringe width, if we know the equation for fringe width is lambda upon 2 mu alpha, lambda it is wavelength of incident light, it is constant. Mu refractive index of the thin film, it is constant. Alpha, that is wedge angle, that is also constant, and therefore the fringes that we get due to this wedge shaped thin film, they are of constant fringe width. And when they will have constant fringe width, when they are straight and parallel to each other. So for using this wedge shaped thin film, we get straight, parallel and equidistant fringes. The example for this straight fringes you can see here. If we take a sample which is perfectly flat and another flat surface, if we keep them in such a way that they will form this wedge, then interference pattern will give you the fringes which are straight, parallel and equidistant to each other, as you can see in this first picture. Whereas if the sample under test, it has curved surface, convex or concave. If it is convex surface, you can see this curved fringes which are moving in outward direction. If it is concave surface, then you will get the fringes like the fringes which are curved like this, curved inside. So we can also use this particular study to find out the flatness, whether the surface of the given sample is exactly perfectly flat or not. So this is one of the application of this thin film interference. So thank you. We will discuss diffraction grating in our next video. We have seen applications of interference due to thin film in this particular video. Thank you so much.